This guy isn't a real patient, and Ashley Lee isn't a real doctor. Just yet, anyway. They're both part of a practice session for Ashley as she learns to diagnose and treat patients. She's a fourth-year medical student at UofL.
So we got some scans and we took some tests to kind of see why you were having all this pain.
It's all being done in the Paris Simulation Center, the Sim Lab, at the University of Louisville Medical School. 9 rooms filled with medical equipment, mannequins, and oftentimes real people who serve as a practice ground for future doctors.
We've done CPR training in here, learning compressions, how to do them on babies versus adults, things like that. We also learned how to do surgical airways in here yesterday and just kind of give you a real life scenario of something that you would see in the hospital.
We have elements of an emergency room, monitors, defibrillators, and crash carts. We have task trainers so we can teach you how to do specific things like how to draw blood, how to start an IV, how to put in a central line, how to deliver babies, how to do a pelvic exam. Just about any clinical procedure that you can think of, there's a trainer for that, and we have most, if not all, of those here.
In the old days, these medical school students would simply watch a doctor or surgeon to learn how to diagnose or do a procedure. Now they can practice on human-like robots. Who can interact with them.
Start shaking really big.
Start shaking like
that. Yeah, if you're gonna make that baby stop crying, you're gonna shake it. And stop crying. All these little red lights represent trauma to the brain. Severed blood vessels, severed arteries, severed veins.
And so when I first saw it, I really didn't understand that, you know, this plastic body can breathe in oxygen and truly breathe out CO2. And so just the realistic nature of, you know, you can actually place lines in chest tubes. I think it's really great training that you can practice in a low-stakes controlled environment before you're put into the hospital and put into a patient encounter.
Mark Eade says not every medical school gives its students this kind of hands-on training.
When I've had friends go on away rotations, they did definitely explain that when they're put in those type of situations, they shine over those who haven't trained here.
Especially when you're talking about intubating, or if you're thinking about how to respond to like a cardiac arrest or something like that, that's something that you want to have practice on before it happens to you for the first time as a physician. So that's why these kind of simulations, I think, it's where they become the most valuable. It allows you to come in to make your mistakes here where there's not necessarily a life that's at risk.